again to watch another digital short. We are finishing up from talking the past few weeks about Bartimaeus, and there's been so much that we have learned through this short study. Again, if you have not watched the past few videos, pause this one and go back to the others so you can watch the rest of the story that we're talking about in order. But as we start, it's time for the weekly bad or dad joke of the week. Here we go. Which is faster, hot or cold? Which is faster, hot or cold? You got it? Obviously, it's hot because you can catch a cold. Ha, okay, whatever. All right, enough of that. Let's move on. Let's read the passage one final time this week. Mark chapter 10, verses 46 through 52 says this. Then they came to Jericho. As Jesus and his disciples, together with a large crowd, were leaving the city, a blind man, Bartimaeus, which means son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. When he heard that it was the son of Nazareth, he began to shout, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Many rebuked him and told him to be quiet, but he shouted all the more, son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus stopped and said, call him. So they called to the blind man, cheer up, on your feet, he's calling you. Throwing his cloak aside, he jumped to his feet and came to Jesus. What do you want me to do for you? Jesus asked the blind and asked him. And the blind man said, Rabbi, I want to see. Go, said Jesus, your faith has healed you. Immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. Now guys, last week we ended the video with this statement. When you approach Jesus, have the faith to toss your cloak. Whatever it is you hold on because of your blindness or your pain or your fear or your insecurity, toss it aside because you know that with Jesus, you don't need it anymore. And this can be really tough, but it's an important step. But what happened, though, after he tossed his cloak proves that Jesus had a sense of humor. Now, there are a handful of moments in the New Testament where Jesus asks what seems like really dumb questions. And this is one of them. Bartimaeus hurried over and Jesus asked in verse 51, what do you want me to do for you? All right, I'm thinking, he's a blind dude, Jesus. What do you think he wants? I imagine the disciples were kind of glancing around at each other and Peter probably whispered, here we go again. But watch how Bartimaeus responded. The blind man said, Rabbi, I want to see. You know, he didn't hesitate. He didn't hold back. He just said it. So the key phrase of the week to text or email to me is, I need to say it. I need to say it. Now, guys, I'm convinced that when we pray, we are not telling God anything that he does not already know. He's not like, oh, so-and-so is sick. Thank you for informing me. I'll get right on that. No. When we pray things, he already knows. So why pray? You know, I think it's partially for us. It's so we can develop a deeper faith and trust in him. Giving our request to God is saying, Lord, I can't do this on my own. I need you and I have faith in you. There's humility and a sense of surrender in actually voicing our needs to God. You know, this feels kind of backwards though, because it's often more difficult to say something than it is to feel it. Does that make sense? We live in a culture where people tend to say whatever they want, but when it really counts, it can be hard to say what we want to say. For example, when you hurt someone and you feel sorry about it, yet for some reason, it's really hard to actually say that you're sorry. It's like saying it makes it even more real that you've messed up. Or as you get older and you fall in love with someone, you feel all that love, but actually saying, I love you, to someone for the first time, guys, is terrifying. Believe me, it's harder than you think when it's real. But Jesus knew that Bartimaeus had faith because he watched him toss his cloak. But then Jesus asked an obvious question to see if Bartimaeus had enough faith to just say it. And what happened when Bartimaeus said, I want to see in verse 51? Verse 52, go, said Jesus, your faith has healed you. Immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. So let's sum all this up for the past few weeks. Bartimaeus was struggling. He literally could not see. So when he heard Jesus was in town, he did four things. One, he cried out. He had nothing left to lose. He was not going to be timid. Two, he pressed in. He refused to be deterred by distractions, discouragement, or doubt. Three, he tossed his cloak. He believed that Jesus was going to heal him before it happened. And then four, he just said it. He had the faith to be real and vulnerable with Jesus. Guys, do you have that kind of faith? Really, do you have that kind of faith? When you're really struggling with something, do you cry out to Jesus? Do you press in? Do you have the faith to toss your cloak and just say it? I believe that Jesus wants you to have a bold, eye-opening faith. I believe that if you cry out and press in and toss your cloak and say it, that he will give you the vision to see what he has planned for you. Whenever you feel blind, you're going through something that you just don't understand, or you just need Jesus to show up in your life, think about Bartimaeus. Do what he did and continue to follow Jesus. Let's pray together. Just follow God right now. I come to you, God. God, I thank you for just loving us, God. God, I thank you that we can come to you, God, and we can share our heart with you, God. We can talk to you. And God, we know that you hear us, God. And God, we ask you just to help us, God, to be like Bartimaeus, God. God, just to really cling to you, God, just in the ways that he did. God, to have the faith and the boldness that he had, Father. God, help us have that in our life, too. Praise in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you guys have a great week. We'll see you next week. Take care. Bye.